In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a fresh install of Windows 10.
Wonder. A sense of wonder.
Well, you have your work cut out for you.
Yes, no matter what the disaster might have been that caused you to have to reinstall, sometimes you have to do it. In this case, we're using a CD to boot from, assuming that the built-in restore doesn't work. And you would go through the options here, basically just choosing your language, in my case, English in Canada. And on the next screen, we want to go to install rather than repair. Repair will attempt to repair the current installation, but we're doing a new one. If you have your product key, enter it here. Otherwise, you can hit skip, especially if the Windows 10 was already existing. It will remember it when you go online next. So you can go ahead and safely hit skip. You have to read and accept the agreement. If it's up to you if you're gonna not read the fine print, but you can hit the checkbox and go next. We're not doing an upgrade in this case. It's a custom install because it's new. And we're not gonna be changing the partitions on here. It's a new drive that's empty, so we'll just go ahead and hit next. Now this actually takes a long time. It took 20 minutes, but I cut it out.
No!
Yeah, so lucky for you, I edited that part of the video, so we just have this short little countdown as it gets ready to reboot and continue. Don't press the key as it prompts you to boot from the CD, otherwise it's going to start over again. Just let it run through. It will prompt you this multiple times throughout the installation as it reboots each time. There it is again. Just let it do its thing. And again, it prompts you for the product key. Enter it if you have it. Otherwise, say don't do it now. You can customize the settings if you want, but in this case, we're going to use the Express settings. It's faster. But if you want the privacy, you can go in and read about customizing your settings and make it a lot more private. This also has been sped up, this part of the video, because this entire process took 45 minutes to do the install on this particular virtual machine. Now here, you want to say that you own the computer in most cases. Otherwise, you would know if it's from work, if it's a company or a school, they would be doing this for you. Now here, if you have a Microsoft account, you can log in with your email address and then go next. In this case, we're going to skip this step. And then we'll be able to create our own local user account name. And if you would like to put a password in, you can put one in as well, which is strongly recommended. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'll just hit next. And that's it. We're logging into Windows for the first time. It runs through quite a bit of this as well. And this actually, for me, took a whole 20 minutes.
Say what?
But not to worry, I cut that out as well. And now we're in Windows, and it comes up first saying that you're connected to a network. If you trust this and you want to share files, you can say yes if it's in your own home or business. Otherwise, you can hit no. And there you go, fresh install of Windows. Thanks for watching.